Good evening and welcome to our evening prayer heading towards night prayer. Thank you for your patience. Thank you, Nick, for putting the note up on the screen. Thank you to Deacon Eddie for setting up, otherwise we'd been later still. If you're considering going out in Guildford, I'd think twice. Something has clearly happened somewhere. It's a complete gridlock of traffic in every direction. I've been up at the school in Rides Hill for a meeting. I've got to get back there for the governor's at 7. It's turning into an interesting day. None of which matters. I think what we're invited to do day by day is to take a breath and to recognize that all is in God's hands. To recognize that if we keep our sights on him, if we remain confident in him and his presence in our lives, then we can allow these other things, important though they are, but we can allow them to take their place. The important thing, whatever the traffic, whatever the meetings, whatever the, is that we come together in prayer. We come to make the center of our lives the center that Mary chose as she gave her yes when the angel came. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may, by his passion and cross, be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, come to our aid. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Alleluia. O Creator, O God, Creator of the world, and King of heaven, sending light, most beautiful to clothe the day, and grace of sleep to come by night, that so in rest our slackened limbs grow strong for work as dawns the day, and wearied minds be fresh again as light drives anxious care away. With bound and thanks, with offered vows, with prayers and hymns our debt we pay, beseeching thee to keep us safe as night draws nigh, as ends the day. The Lord surrounds his people. Those who put their trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion that cannot be shaken, that stands forever. Jerusalem, the mountains surround her, so the Lord surrounds his people, both now and forever. For the sceptre of the wicked shall not rest over the land of the just, for fear that the hands of the just should turn to evil. Do good, Lord, to those who are good, to the upright of heart, but the crooked and those who do evil, drive them away. On Israel, peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord surrounds his people. Unless you become like little children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. O Lord, my heart is not proud, nor haughty my eyes. I've not gone after things too great, nor marvels beyond me. Truly I've set my soul in silence and peace. A weaned child on its mother's breast, even so is my soul. O Israel, hope in the Lord, both now and forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Unless you become like little children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. Lord, you have made us a kingdom and priests to serve our God. Worthy are you, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honour and power, for you created all things, and by your will they existed and were created. Worthy are you, O Lord, to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed men for God, from every tribe and tongue and people and nation. You have made us a kingdom and priests to our God, and we shall reign on earth. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honour and glory and blessing. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Lord, you have made us a kingdom and priests to serve our God. From the letter to the Romans. Do not let your love be a pretense, but sincerely prefer good to evil. Love each other as much as brothers should, and have a profound respect for each other. Work for the Lord with untiring effort and with great earnestness of spirit. If you have hope, this will make you cheerful. Do not give up if trials come, and keep on praying. Your word, O Lord, will endure forever. Your truth will last from age to age. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. My spirit exalts in the Lord God, my Saviour. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me. Holy his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones and raises the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his sons forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. My spirit exalts in the Lord God, my Saviour. God has established his people in hope. Nothing can break the confidence of those who love him. Let us proclaim, Father, our trust is in you. We give you thanks, Lord God, for you have made man rich in all wisdom and insight. Lord God, you know the hearts of all rulers. May they work for the good of the people they govern. Lord, you empower people to glorify this world with art. Make our work live with vision and true hope. You do not allow us to be tempted beyond our limits. Strengthen the weak, raise up the fallen. Father, you've promised us a share in your Son's resurrection on the last day. Remember those who've gone before us on the path to eternal life. Una asks that we might join them in praying for the soul of Caroline, who died on Saturday, for a grieving husband, Jeremy, brother of Bill, and all her friends. May she rest in peace. Asked to pray for the candidates who are on the RCA program. We pray that as they come closer to the Lord, he may strengthen their faith and give them confidence in their choice. We've been at a meeting this afternoon and again this evening. It's a reminder that we should pray for our schools. The Holy Father had asked that this autumn schools and Catholic education be part of our prayer. We give thanks particularly for all those who minister in them. Pray too for Catholic Society at Surrey University, being currently formed, that it may give a great witness of faith. We pray for David Corning, that he may rest in peace. We pray for peace in the Middle East. And for peace in Ukraine. We pray for all those who have no one to remember them by name, particularly the names here in front of the altar, that they may know that gift of eternal life. We pray for Father Michael Lane, priest of this diocese, whose anniversary occurs today. And we pray for all those to whom we've promised our intercession before God. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. Let our evening prayer rise up before your throne of mercy, Lord, and let your blessing come down upon us, so that now and forever your grace may help and save us. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Thank you again for your patience and for your prayers. May the Lord grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, Espes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Evae, a te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes loculos, et nos converte. Et Iesum benedictum fruntum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O duces, Virgo Maria. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Pius, pray for us. Saint Edward, pray for us. All holy men and women, pray for us.